Hello, love. Welcome home to Eden. This is Love Life with Eve. I'm your Love Life muse, so stick with me for the hottest news and subscribe to this channel to get somewhere new. Let's talk about why women use sex as a weapon and how to reverse this. You don't need that, do you? Well, there are a number of things to keep in mind because, for example, I'm a woman who doesn't ever want to use sex as a weapon. I want it to be a given. I want that to be the one thing that my lover and I can count on, you know? But I find over and over again when I do, when I open myself in a generous way with my lover or with a man, he finds that he sort of gets into this entitled attitude, like, okay, so I got what I wanted, so I'm disappearing. Whatever she wanted, I'll put it on the back burner. And then I find, okay, so the only way to get him to respond to more of me, to all of me as a human soul, as a friend, as a companion, is to withhold the sex until he gets the message, right? I made a video about why sluts are the truest hearted women. Basically, you know, talking about how the woman who is free and open in her sexuality and generously wanting to connect with her man is in a pleasure story. She's saying yes to her pleasure and his pleasure and the joy of that. And you want to reverse this, okay? You want to reverse this problem. So first thing is to look at how you're taught that the women who are generous sexually are less valuable, are sluts, whores, prostitutes in your unconscious mind, and how you begin to dismiss a woman who is erotically alive, or how you begin to fantasize, obsess about her as a goddess who's no longer a human friend. So how to hold the two polarities of her goddess tantric expressions that are so otherworldly and blow your mind with the daily woman who's making breakfast and hanging out and has a world purpose that she's serving, is to say to yourself that all these parts of you are valuable. You are not just valuable to her as as a sex god or as a provider or all those ways that men compartmentalize the relationships with women as either the whore or the prostitute or the wife or the mistress or the friend. Can you get into a holistic, whole spirit, whole body, whole mind place? And this means that you're saying, ah, we're going to connect on our seven chakras, not just the sexual chakra or not just the providing, grounding chakra. Seven chakras, that means, you know, from all the way from your grounded security place to your sexual creativity place to your sharing power in your power center, to your heart expansion place, to your communication place, and sharing full communication from the heart, to your clairvoyant, beautiful mind space, creative mind, to your spiritual, you know, woo, euphoric place, connecting right back down to the root, not divorced from sexuality, but as a circle, as a rainbow circle. So if you go from red at the bottom all the way up through orange, yellow, green, blue, lavender, magenta, now magenta is bringing you back to red again. You see how the whole thing is a circle, and that the root connects to spirit, right? So, and the root is very close to the sexual chakra. So, and now you get to mystical sexuality where all seven chakras are the plan. That's the plan with her, okay? So as soon as you get to understanding that women are almost always, unless she's cut off at some place, almost always a woman who's really true-hearted, and usually it's the slut women, what they're really asking for is full connection on all levels. And if you enter the dance with her on these different levels, she doesn't withhold sex anymore as a weapon. That's just the given, the way, the place to enter through your sexuality. At that point, you can enter any chakra. You can enter power, you can enter creativity, you can enter love, you can enter spirituality. See what I mean? This, then the sexuality, it's not withheld. It is the doorway to all these other connections. But you've got to give yourself freedom to be like, hey, the guy in me who is creative, say, and expressive, he's goofy. He's not the lover man who's so, like, you know, in control. And my sexual chakra, I've got this lover man who's such a Romeo, you know, and loves to play those games of dominant energy. And it's all okay, right? Because you have these other parts of you. You're the man who provides for the family. Maybe he's really heart-centered, and he also likes to take off time from work to provide love too. And maybe the part of you that's an empowered guy, he's just really, like, kind of down home and practical and not so mystical or magical. He's just talking straight, you know? So letting yourself be all those different guys with her and feeling safe enough that all those guys are valuable to her gives her the freedom that you're saying, hey, I actually want to know those other parts of you. I want to know the goofy girl. I want to know the one who's doing the errands and making jokes with her friends about the internet. I want to know the one who is, like, in this mystical, euphoric place with nature on a shamanic journey of her own. I want to know the one who's a wild pagan secret witch, you know, like being open to all the different sides of her. I want to know that one who's so cold and clinical and so matter of fact and such a good businesswoman. You know, I'm interested to be affected by all these levels of you. Okay? Now you're talking sexuality being used as the sacred doorway to all levels of connection rather than withheld in order to wake you up that there are these other levels of connection she needs. Got it, love? You got it? It's going to be so much more fun now for you and me. Okay.